There is a piece of paper stuck on our fridge. It's always been there. My big brother Paul says he remembers a time before the piece of paper was stuck on the fridge, but Paul makes stuff up. This is what it says. No knives, no playing outside, always wash your hands. Mum and Dad say these rules are non-negotiable, which is a word that I find hard to say. Also on the fridge is a picture of Mum and Dad in Hawaii. Hawaii looks so cool. I want to go, but Mum says I can't because there's no planes anymore. I don't care. I go to Hawaii in my head. When I'm sad, I say I'm going to Hawaii. Paul says I'm an idiot, but he's the actual idiot because it was his idea to go into the woods that day, and if he hadn't, then none of this would have happened. So there.
Truth About Hawaii, Episode 1, The Scratch.
Day after it happened is the answer to all our problems.
You think we should wait?
Yes.
Until when, David? Huh? Give me a date. I can't stand this, hanging around, waiting for something terrible to happen.
They're arguing more and more these days. Paul says it's because they're old and don't love each other. I think it's because Mrs. Patterson next door died last night. Mrs. Patterson had cancer. It wasn't bad cancer, but she got an infection and that was that. Mrs. Patterson is the third person to die on our street in a year.
Listen, things need to be put in place. Where do you think we're going to get the money from? It's not like the housing market's booming.
We will make do.
Yeah, but there's no point moving to the country if all we can afford is an old bothy with a leaky roof and no blooming electricity.
That is not what I meant, you know it.
I don't want to move. I like it here. I like my bedroom. It has blue walls like the sea in the morning and a picture of a volcano in the corner.
All right, idiot.
Oh, that hurt.
Chill. Have you got your period or something?
Haha, you're not funny.
What's the problem today? I swear they're getting worse.
Mrs. Patterson.
Who cares? She was a smelly old cow.
She was nice. I liked her cat. What happens to her cat?
Oh, it's so boring. I will die of boredom before I'm even 16.
Is that medically possible?
Why don't you keep talking and we'll find out. You've given me a dead arm.
Ha ha.
I know, but why not just wait till the end of the year and see where we are?
End of the year?
Shall we get out of here?
Where to?
The woods. I pinched a vape off next door.
It's against the rules.
So what? Are you scared?
Of course not.
Well then, let's go, because I'm sick of the racket. Once upon a time, this wasn't a field. It was a car park. And this whole stretch of the meadow was a car park. It's a big posh school, private school. And can you imagine? A school is a place where kids used to have lessons. And it's like what we do at home with Dad, apart from big rooms with lots of other kids.
You know what school is, Paul?
Clever girl.
I went to school.
No, you didn't.
I did, for a term.
I miss school. It was rubbish, but you got to hang out with your mates. The TV says most schools in Scotland are closing down. Everyone's keeping their kids at home. Would you like to go to school, Sarah?
Maybe.
Do you want a bit of this?
Is it nice?
No.
Then no.
Right, we better get a move on. Sooner or later, the parents will realise we've gone. And they'll set the police on us.
20, 19, 18, 17,
Mum and Dad don't talk 16, about how it was before. 15, before 14, the antibiotics 13, stopped working. 12, they think not talking 11, makes it better, 10, but it doesn't.
9, 8, 7,
Paul tells me
6,
horror stories to scare me,
5,
but he's the scared one.
4,
everyone is scared,
3,
except me.
2,
I'm not afraid of 1, anything.
Coming, ready or not.
You'll never find me.
Shut up, Paul. You're spoiling it.
The funny thing about not being scared is that you're not always looking where you're going.
Oh!
What happened?
I fell over.
Are you all right?
I scratched myself.
You better not be faking or I will kill you. Oh, shit.
What?
It looks bad.
Does it?
No, it looks really bad, Sarah.
I'll lick it.
Oh my god, that's disgusting.
I like the taste of blood.
You're giving me the poke. Does it hurt?
A bit.
Mum and Dad are gonna kill you.
Me?
You're not meant to go outside.
It was your idea.
That is a good point. Better not tell them then.
How? My jeans are ruined.
You can patch them up.
Mum hides the needles, remember?
Alright, it's bleeding quite a lot now. Can you not stop it?
No.
Put your hand on it or something.
It's not working. What are we gonna do?
Get my back. I'll carry you. Just don't say anything until you're home and tidied up.
Oh my god, what have you done?
It's nothing, Dad, it's a scratch.
That's not a scratch.
It doesn't hurt.
Doesn't it? There's blood everywhere.
Sorry.
What on earth were you doing outside?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Just playing.
Where?
The woods.
The woods?
Ah!
I told you not to say anything.
What were you doing taking your little sister to the woods, Paul? You know the rules.
Chill, Dad. It's not a big deal.
We'll see about that when your mother comes home.
Does Mum have to know?
I think she might notice a gaping wound in her daughter's knee. Are you sure it doesn't hurt? It looks really painful.
It's a scratch.
Have you washed it?
I licked it. Saliva is nature's antiseptic.
Who told you that?
You did.
Okay. Look, well, we better get it washed properly. Let's get you out of those jeans and into the bath. Paul, are you going to turn on the water, please? And not a word to your Mum. Absolute radio silence.
Sarah?
Hi, Mum. Did you have a good day at work?
What's the matter with your leg? You're limping. Why are you limping? What's going on?
Nothing.
David, why is she limping?
Well, it sounds worse than it is.
Is an impressive scratch, Sarah. What were you doing?
I fell over.
Happens to the best of us. I once fell off a wall at Stirling Castle, broke my arm. Never been able to lift it above my head since. Look.
But is it infected, Doctor?
Difficult to say at this point. Possibly.
Oh, God.
Now, there's no need for alarm. A little swelling and redness, that's all. Give it a day or two.
What happens if there is an infection?
Most likely it will be self-limiting. The bacteria will burn itself out and that will be that.
What if it doesn't?
Then you come back and we work out what the next best step is.
Can't you give her something?
You can give her paracetamol if it hurts. Does it hurt, Sarah?
Not much.
Brave girl. Do you want a Haribo?
What about antibiotics? Can't you give her antibiotics?
Once upon a time, perhaps.
Oh, that's crazy. I mean, she's a little girl.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.